So one of the unexpected pleasures and privileges that you receive when you become president of SFN is that there will be a meeting logo designed that in some sense encapsulates you as a researcher.
It's been one of the greatest honors for me personally to be able to work on such a profound logo. It embodies, you know, our incoming president's lifetime of research.
This wonderfully talented artist, Amit, presented how he evolved the logo from reading about what I did and looking at some of my papers.
There's a multi-phased approach that I like to take with the annual meeting logo to ensure that it's scientifically accurate and that it's visually appealing. The first phase that I like to do is research. When I began working on Dr. Everitt's logo, I did a lot of research specifically about drug addiction and the different mechanisms in the brain that he was focused on in his lab.
Because I have no artistic skills at all, and my mind immediately went to thinking, how on earth could anyone encapsulate what I do in a logo?
What I wanted to showcase in this logo was the reward circuit and the different parts of the brain through the use of circles. And you can see that loop happening in the brain. Because I also wanted to depict like the energy of the meeting, you know, so I had to have some kind of motion, feeling inspired when you go to the meeting. And so those are the emotions that I was trying to convey in the annual meeting logo. Then the next phase is the design phase. And I start to sketch about, I'd say anywhere from like 20, 30, 40 different logo concepts. And through Adobe Illustrator, I'll start sketching those out on the computer. What I like to show is, in my initial concepts, is very abstract ideas, where they're very abstract shapes, to more literal, where it closely resembles the science in its literal form. There's a constant interplay happening. You know, it was a lot of modifications to the style of, you know, line that I was using, the circles that I was using. I present those digital sketches to the in-house PhDs. They are the secret to the success of this logo, making sure that I'm comparing them to the original research and staying scientifically accurate.
Because somehow, it does encapsulate what my research has been about for the last 25 or 30 years, which is trying to understand the neural circuits and systems in the brain that are involved in the development of addiction and which may be the targets of new treatments for addiction. And so they're encapsulated on this schematic in representations of circuits which are completely abstract. Somehow our structures like the amygdala and the nucleus accumbens and the dorsal striatum and the prefrontal cortex and the midbrain dopamine neurons and the way they interact as circuits underlying behavior and cognition.
We take the final concepts and we present them to our executive director. And then he presents them at the fall council meeting, at the annual meeting.
And what came up, I think, took only seconds for everyone to appreciate, was very stunning. And there were intakes of breath and indeed applause when this appeared on the screen.
There's an aha moment, you know, with each viewer once they realize, oh, that's what they're looking at, you know, and then they get it, you know. That's where I feel like a logo is successful.
And I think it's a beautiful image. It's a wonderful representation in an abstract way of what I spend my life doing and what I remain committed to and interested in.